episode of EBS의 생활영어. I'm Megan Bowen.
안녕하세요, 여러분. EBS 생활영어의 선현우입니다. 반갑습니다. 네. 선생님, 안녕하세요.
안녕하십니까.
What did this mean?
I don't know.
그 나라에 따라서 이거를 굉장히 자주 하는 나라가 있던데요. 네,
yeah.
I forgot.
That would be Korea.
No, other than Korea.
Oh, other than
한국 말고 Korea? 그 사진 찍을 때나 인사할 때 이렇게 많이 하는 나라가 있어요. 갑자기 생각이 안 나는데 혹시 여러분 아시면 홈페이지에
yeah.
알려주시고요.
Let us know.
네, 아무튼 이거하고 이 포즈하고 오늘의 주제는 관계는 없습니다.
Yeah.
오늘 주제, 아까 제목에서 보신 것처럼 인공지능 메신저. 이것을 영어로 어떻게 표현하는지 생각해 보시는 것도 mm-hmm. 좋겠고요. 그런데 mm-hmm. 오늘 우리가 준비한 표현이 하나 있죠.
Mm-hmm. Of course, we have prepared a term for you guys today. And of course, we're not going to just tell you. You'll take a look at the monologue. And through that, we hope you can guess today's keyword. 키워드. What are you doing right now? I'm chatting with you. Okay, is this not a real person? Because I thought I was chatting with a real person, but apparently it's just some type of robot. Huh. So these days online, there are a lot of computer simulators that can actually simulate real conversation. Essentially, they're robots that are chatting with you. And I see it a lot with customer service at online stores. They always pop up and they're like, hey, a representative is here to chat with you. And then you chat with them and you realize, wait a minute, that was a very weird answer. This is probably a robot. This is not a person. I know it. So that's today's keyword. What today's keyword is comprised of is basically two parts. One of them is chat or chatting, like having a conversation with someone or sending messages, chatting, and robots. You kind of take chat and a shortened way to say robot, and you have today's keyword.
로봇이라고 하는 단어까지도 나왔는데요. Mm-hmm. 오늘의 그러면 키워드는 무엇인지 확인해 보겠습니다.
Okay, today's keyword is chatbot. Chatbot.
Chat box 아니고
bot.
Bot. 그러니까 robot. Mm-hmm. 여기에 bot를 그대로 붙여준 거군요.
Mm-hmm.
실제로 일단 로봇의 발음부터 해보죠.
Mm-hmm.
로봇.
Robot. Robot.
Robot.
Mm-hmm.
Row 마치 이제 그 노젓는 것처럼 rowing 하는 것처럼 row 발음하신 다음에 but.
Mm-hmm.
그리고 우리가 흔히 그 하지만 그런데라고 할 때 쓰는 그 but 하고는 좀 발음이 달라요.
Yes. So it's quite different from but but.
Mm-hmm.
But.
But.
Mm-hmm.
그래서 robot 이렇게 해야 이제 로봇을 가리키고
mm-hmm.
너무 O 쪽으로 해서 robot 이렇게 말하면 mm-hmm. 오해를 할 수도 있고 아니면 mm-hmm. 못 알아들을 수도 있어요.
Mm-hmm.
아무튼 그 bot이라고 하는 부분이 chat 뒤에 붙어서 chatbot 이렇게 됐는데요.
Mm-hmm.
이것은 음성이 될 수도 있겠고 텍스트가 될 수도 있겠고
Right. So it could be an actual voice, like if you call a calling center,
yeah.
or it can actually just be text, like, you know, written down.
네, 그렇죠. 자동응답으로 mm-hmm. 보통 그 소비자를 도와주는 어떤 서비스죠.
Mm-hmm. 네. They usually to help us consumers.
Yes. Chatbot에 대해서 오늘 이야기를 해보겠습니다.
Mm-hmm. All right, so we're going to have a little conversation about chatbots. Hyunwoo Sim has prepared three questions as usual. You guys, make sure you answer along with me.
네, 여러분도 같이 제가 준비한 그 질문들 세 개 대답을 해보세요.
Mm-hmm.
첫 번째, How often do you chat with a chatbot? 뭐 얼마나 자주 chatbot 자동응답 그 로봇 시스템과 얼마나 자주 이야기를 나누게 되시나요? 여러분이 뭐 한번 나는 이야기 해야겠다라고 생각하는 건 아니잖아요.
Yeah, I would just say too often.
Too often.
Yeah.
So you use a service and
yeah.
they present you with an opportunity to mm-hmm. chat with a chatbot.
Yes. Too
yeah.
often.
Yeah.
I would say at least once a week.
Once a week?
Yeah, because usually when I'm sending, like if I'm transferring money somewhere, mm-hmm. the bank will have to do a check. Mm-hmm. So they'll call me with an automated voice and I have to push the button to prove that it's me.
그렇죠.
So maybe once a week or so?
일주일에 한 번.
Yeah.
그렇군요. 저는 한 달에 한 번 정도인 것 같은데.
Oh, really?
네. 그리고 그런 거 있어요. 그 전화하는 거는 아무래도 전화할 때부터 일단 그 실제로 상담원 이 나오시기 전에 뭔가 메시지가 나올 거를 어느 정도 예상할
mm-hmm.
수 있잖아요. 그런데 온라인 스토어 같은 경우에 보면은 그냥 뭐 둘러보려고 하는데 팝업 창이 뜨면서 팝업 윈도우가 뜨면서 Gosh. 그때 말을 걸 때가 있죠. That's yeah. not expected.
It's not expected. And that is the most frustrating one, I would
okay,
say.
Okay, okay. Let's talk a little more about this later on.
Okay.
자, 여러분은 얼마나 자주 자동응답 메시지와 이야기를 그 로봇 메시지와 또는 인공지능 메시지와 이야기를 나누게 되시나요?
Yeah, 네. we would love to know. Let us know.
알려주세요. 두 번째 질문 드리겠습니다.
Okay.
So when was the last time you talked with a chatbot? For you, I guess it was last week?
No, actually it was this morning. I had to transfer some money somewhere. So I was in the studio uh-huh. and I had to play it and then listen and then push the button.
아, 그런 것도 chatbot이라고 부르긴 하는 거죠?
Yeah. So anytime there's an automated voice that prompts you to do something, mm-hmm. then we call that a chatbot.
네, mm-hmm. 채팅을 나누는 로봇이라고 해서 mm-hmm. 그 자동화된 시스템은 다 chatbot이라고 부를 수가 있습니다. Mm-hmm. 뭐 사람에 따라서 그 보통 그 텍스트만 chatbot이라고 부르는 사람도 있겠고 mm-hmm. 어떤 사람은 인터넷을 잘 안 한다. 그냥 전화 쪽 서비스만 mm-hmm. 많이 이제 접하게 된다 해서 mm-hmm. 음성 쪽을 먼저 생각할 수도 있겠습니다.
Yeah, but they're both. So what about you? A month ago?
Yeah, I think it was a month ago.
Okay.
And I tried to avoid the chatbot mm-hmm. because I didn't really want to type anything in there. Mm-hmm. But it just kept following me every page I went.
Yes. I was on an online store mm. maybe 2 weeks ago, and I needed help
okay.
Knowing if they shipped to Korea. And mm. then suddenly it just popped up, and it said, we're online. Yeah. So I was like, oh, it must be a person because mm-hmm. it says, we're online. Mm-hmm. But it wasn't.
그렇군요. 막 돌아다니고 있는데 떠서 we're online. 저는 이제 we're online이라는 말도 안 뜨고 궁금한 게 있으면 여기 써주세요. Yeah. 뭐 이런 식으로 나왔었어요. 그래서 이제 넘어갔는데 그렇게 나오면 사람인 줄 알 수도 있겠어요?
Yeah. So I actually thought it was a person, so I replied, and then they didn't understand, so I said, chatbot.
Okay, okay. I understand. It's very relatable.
Uh-huh.
자, 그럼 세 번째 질문으로 넘어가 볼까요?
Okay.
네. For a customer, mm-hmm. 소비자 입장에서, are there any advantages of using a chatbot? Mm-hmm. 사업체 입장에서는 사실 이점들이 분명히 있어요. Mm-hmm. 그냥 그 고객이 다른 웹사이트로 가버리는 것을 막고 잡아둔다는 mm-hmm. 이점이 있는데 고객 입장에서는 어떤 이점이 있을까요?
Well, I can think of two right okay. now. Mm-hmm. The first one is some things you can do faster 아. on the phone mm-hmm. if it's just click a button and then this happens.
Yeah, yeah.
yeah.
And then?
And the second one would be after hours you can do things at night sometimes.
Okay, that's a big yeah. advantage. 네. Mm-hmm. 그 근무 시간 이외에도 뭔가 mm-hmm. 서비스를 얻을 수 있다는 것이 큰 장점이 되겠네요. Mm-hmm. 저도 갑자기 생각이 났는데 그 아까 oh. 첫 번째 말씀하신 거랑 연관이 있어요. Mm-hmm. So you talk to a person, okay? Mm-hmm. A real person. Mm-hmm. And you give all the details, you tell them all the story, mm-hmm. and everything is just all given to them.
Right.
And then maybe if it's a person, this person can say, Let me transfer you to another person.
Yes.
그럴 때 저도 있었거든요. 이제 실제 사람하고 대화를 하게 되면 좋은데 정보를 한참 말하고 나서 그때 아 그거는 다른 담당자가 할 것 같습니다.
Yeah.
yeah. And then they answer and so what can I help you with?
Yes.
Yeah.
And then you have to do it again.
So, all over again.
So sometimes before you talk to them, if the chatbot says for this, press this.
Yes.
You can already be there.
You can already. More directly go to the person right. that you need to actually talk to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure. Okay. okay, so let us know, did we miss any? We'd love to know. And before we move on, let's take a look at the monologue one more time. What are you doing right now? I'm chatting with you. Okay, is this not a real person? Because I thought I was chatting with a real person, but apparently it's just some type of robot. Huh. So these days online, there are a lot of computer simulators that can actually simulate real conversation. Essentially, they're robots that are chatting with you. And I see it a lot with customer service at online stores. They always pop up and they're like, hey, a representative is here to chat with you. And then you chat with them and you realize, wait a minute, that was a very weird answer. This is probably a robot. This is not a person. I know it. So that's today's keyword. What today's keyword is comprised of is basically two parts. One of them is chat or chatting, like having a conversation with someone or sending messages, chatting, and robot. You kind of take chat and a shortened way to say robot, and you have today's keyword.